all of the lights on the 49ers side of the Superdome are out.
Hey guys, what's happening and welcome back to our channel. Sports continue to depend more and more on modern technology. Leagues of all sports worldwide are adding complicated replay systems for officials. Coaches are counting on computers to help them make key decisions during games. Stadiums are powering huge facilities to support crowds. Officials have to broadcast live streams to millions of people around the world. But sometimes technology breaks down right in front of our eyes. So let's check out the craziest equipment malfunctions in sports history. Number 5. Super Bowl 47 Lights Out. During the Ravens 49ers Super Bowl match, half of the lights in the Superdome went out during the third quarter, halting play for a massive 34 minutes. A statement released by Entergy, the power supplier of the Superdome, noted an abnormality, also followed by the statement, a piece of equipment that is designed to monitor electrical load sensed an abnormality in the system. Once the issue was detected, the sensing equipment operated as designed and opened a breaker, causing power to be partially cut to the Superdome to isolate the issue. Looking at the somewhat of a hilarious malfunction, the players were not hesitant to speak up. I'm not gonna accuse nobody of nothing, because I don't know facts, but you're a zillion-dollar company and your lights go out? No, laughs, no way, Ravens linebacker Ray Lewis said.
All of the lights on the 49ers side of the Superdome are out.
Number 4, NFL sideline technology. In a lengthy rant, Patriots coach Bill Belichick recently denounced the tablets used on NFL sidelines, calling the technology too undependable. Belichick's comments aimed at the Microsoft Surface revealed the complexity of communication between NFL players, coaches, and officials. Here's what he had to say. There are very few games where there aren't issues in some form or fashion with that equipment. And again, there's a lot of equipment involved too. We get the equipment the day of the game, or I'd say not the day of the game, but a few hours before the game, and we test it, and sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. Usually by game time it is working, but I would say not always. And then during the game, sometimes something happens and it has to be fixed, and first of all, you have to figure out what the problem is. Is it a battery? Is it the helmet? Is it the coach's pack? Or is it the battery on the coach's pack? I'm done with the tablets. I'll use the paper pictures from here on because I've given it my best shot. I've tried to work through the process, but it just doesn't work for me, and that's because there's no consistency to it. While Belichick is frustrated with Surface's utility, others have simply taken out their frustration on the poor device. Just ask Johnny Manziel and Aaron Rodgers after they both threw tantrums in public
during a recent loss to the Buffalo Bills. See, the NFL is in the middle of a $400 million five-year deal with Microsoft to exclusively use the tablets on all NFL sidelines. That is a situation with which Bill Belichick has had enough.
Number 3, VAR video assistant referee fails to give Atletico Madrid an obvious penalty versus Chelsea. Now this one is a more recent incident. Neither the on-pitch referee nor the VAR officials watching the Champions League last 16-second leg on screens saw anything wrong with the Chelsea FC centre-back Azpilicueta pulling back Yannick Carrasco as he burst through on goal. VAR didn't even appear to review it, which drove several Atletico Madrid rooting fans angry. While not a dangerous challenge overall, the Chelsea defender still seemed to clearly pull back the arm of Carrasco as he ran towards the goal, looking to capitalize on Azpilicueta's under-hit back pass. It's a penalty you see given regularly in a modern football game. Adding salt to the wound, Chelsea took the first half lead on that night, less than 10 minutes after Atletico Madrid should almost certainly have had a spot kick. Hakim Ziyech finished off an excellent counterattack to put Chelsea 1-0 up at Stamford Bridge and 2-0 up on aggregate in the tie as Diego Simeone's side faced a huge hurdle in the second half. This is also unfortunate for Atletico, as that penalty kick could have been the tide change of the combined aggregate, and it might just have given them a chance to advance in the quarterfinals of the 2021 Champions League.
To me, it seems clearly as a penalty.
Number 2, 2014 NBA Finals, broken air conditioning. The first game of the 2014 NBA Finals was a warm one, like straight out of an oven. An electrical malfunction shut down the AT&T Arena's AC, which caused on-court temperatures to rise above 90 degrees Fahrenheit. The heat took a toll on some players, most notably LeBron James, who had to sit out most of the fourth quarter because of cramps and seizures. I lost all the fuse that I was putting in the last couple of days out there on the floor. It sucks not being there for your team, especially at this point in the season, LeBron James is reported to have said. Other NBA legends didn't back out on this move by LeBron. Michael Jordan absolutely could not have played through those cramps. I absolutely couldn't have played through those cramps. As an athlete, there's nothing you could do. Hall of Famer Isaiah Thomas said.
Danny Green wide open from the slot for three, and then usually you don't want to see Danny Green put the ball on the ground, but all of Babylon sees him flush it on top of Rashard Lewis. 8 big points for Green so far.
Number 1, the FIFA World Cup 2018 final VAR fail. Now this is when things get extra serious, as this is supposed to be the World Cup final of the biggest sport in the world. So any little malfunction in equipment can be costly. Paul Pogba and Kylian Mbappe both scored very fine goals in the second half of the World Cup final, but the moment in which the title was won by France came much earlier, after 33 minutes of the match whistle. Antoine Griezmann swung in a corner from the right, and at the near post, Blaise Matuidi jumped with Ivan Perisic. The ball flicked off the French midfielder, hit the Croatian, and bounced out of play. The Argentinian referee Nestor Pitana gave a goal kick. A crowd of French players surrounded him, appealing for handball. Pitana got a word in his ear and went to look at the video. What he saw was the ball strike Perisic, who was unsighted by Matuidi and almost certainly wouldn't have had the time to react to the deflection anyway. His hand was down by his side in the most natural position imaginable, and yet, somehow, Pitana ruled it was deliberate. In Pitana's defense, it was not too dissimilar to the penalty given to Iran in its game against Portugal. Perhaps referees have been instructed at this tournament that that is to be considered a foul. But realistically, that is nonsense. It means that any player in the box is in perpetual danger of conceding a penalty. I never comment on refereeing, said Croatia coach Zlatko Dalic after his team was defeated 4-2, but let me say one sentence. In a World Cup final, you do not give such a penalty. Our condolences are for sure with the Croatian team, as 2018 might just have been their year of glory and pride, because it was the first time in years that the Croatian national team went this far.
This is what Dalic had to say after the game. The Croatian coach said, I never speak about referees, but let me say this. In a final, you don't give such a penalty, but it doesn't diminish France's victory. They deserve to win, and I congratulate them.
But do let us hear your thoughts regarding these equipment malfunctions in sporting events, especially the finals of any sport, in the comments section below. And before we get out of here, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. And with that, I'll be catching you guys later in another video. Bye now!